Welcome back, Sweet Chris here. In this video, I'm gonna walk you through the AI tools that currently exist in NetSuite as of the first half of 2024. Now, if you saw my NetSuite news video for the month of June, you know I already commented on this a little bit, but in this video, I'm gonna dive a little bit deeper and I'm gonna actually walk you through some of these tools in NetSuite. So first, let's just give a bit of background. In early 2023, the whole world started going crazy on the subject of AI. In October 2023, SuiteWorld happened, which is really NetSuite's big convention for the year. It's their showcase for a lot of their new products, their features, etc. So in SuiteWorld 2023, they were going full on for the subject of AI. It was all about how NetSuite's gonna be fully infused with AI and AI is gonna completely change how NetSuite operates. And they were talking about how they had partnered with this large language model company called Cohere. So that was all kind of alleged. They were all saying this was gonna come out in October 2023. And then in April 2024, when the first release happened for NetSuite, that was the real first instance where some of these tools actually came out that people can interact with. So that happened, and it was kind of NetSuite's opportunity to put their money where their mouth was in terms of all the things that they promised in the SuiteWorld 2023. So in the end, in that first release in April 2024, NetSuite came out with three specific AI tools or integrations in with NetSuite. And there was a couple very, very small things in addition to that, but really nothing to write home about. So it was kind of all focused on these three specific tools. So in this video, I'm gonna walk you through two of the tools and also comment on the third one. So let's start with the first tool, which is the enhanced text feature. So let's take a look at this. Okay, so to demonstrate text enhance, which is a lot like ChatGPT, honestly, in terms of what it's doing. So let's pull up, we're gonna go to a list, accounting, items, and new. Now, this feature is not only on item records, it's in a couple other places where you can put descriptions of things, but items are definitely one of the most obvious examples of it. So I'm gonna open up as if I'm creating a new inventory item. So it brings us to this inventory item, and let's say we're gonna put in a pump motor. So that's our new item. And if I come down here under purchasing inventory, we've got this purchase description box with this AI tool. So we could do it here. However, it also exists under sales pricing. So I'm going to show it on this one. And this is the customer facing sales description, right? So if I click on the AI tool, we've got a few different options. So I could type in some basic text, which I'm gonna do in a second, and it can clean it up, like looking for typos, it can generate additional text, it can make it longer, shorter, etc. So let's put in some basic info. Let's say it is a pump motor, it's more efficient, it's 5.5 pounds, and let's say it's compatible with multiple brands. So a very simple description, and I can come over here and I can say, all right, generate a better description, right? Use the AI model to try to figure out exactly what this should say. So it does it pretty rapidly. I'm gonna make this bigger. I'm gonna scroll down here a little bit. And as you can see, by the way, I didn't actually test this specific text out before this video. So you're getting a really good representation of what problem you can actually run into. You can tell immediately that this is not a helpful sales description. So it attempted to fill in fields and things like that, and it ended up, and you'll see it did make some new text, such as saying that it's a core feature that makes the product stand out. I did test it out on some other words and some product names, and there were instances where I could figure it out and it gave me a description. It leans in the direction of being too salesy, meaning really hyping up what this thing is doing. But let's try this out. Again, this is the first time in terms of this exact text. So let's see what happens if we hit clean up. Okay, so at least it took a lot of the jargon and the kind of almost like scripting language off the table. Although not all of it, there's still plenty of different things going on here that are not particularly helpful. And what happens if we come and we say make longer? So I actually had to cut some time out of the recording because that took a pretty significant amount of time to load. And as you can see, it does fill in some additional things. Find out how you can use the pump motor in your next project, discover its feature and highlights, and decide whether it's the right tool for you. So again, this is just random text. This is not particularly helpful for a sales description. It's almost like marketing copy. So not particularly helpful. Honestly, if I really wanted to use this tool or this type of thing, I would open up ChatGPT in a different browser. I would simply type the same thing into ChatGPT. I would give it some specific commands, which you can't do with this tool. You're limited to these very specific options. Whereas in ChatGPT, you can give it all kinds of different commands to try to hone in exactly what you want. And then I would have it generate something for me. I'd fix it as needed, and then I would copy and paste it into this field. If I wanted to use a tool like this, which I don't even particularly think this is a very helpful tool to begin with. Again, this was like the first thing that NetSuite led with on their new AI capabilities. So if it's helpful for you, then great. I do think it has a long way to come in terms of even this tool's exact capabilities. Right now, I would just use ChatGPT to handle this exact problem. Overall, there's a lot of things that could be done with this type of thing. I would love to see more efficiency in terms of, like, for example, when you're filling in new records, things like that, using AI to intuitively fill in fields or just automatically populate information that it is predicting you're gonna have to type in anyways, so that there's less clicks. Currently, the only real way to do that is to make a lot of custom fields and workflows and scripts that do a lot of that automation. But it'd be great if an AI tool could use what it knows you've done in the past and modify and really populate information ahead of you to make your work more efficient. And of course, instances where it did it wrong and you had to correct it and put in new information, it'd be great if it learned from that and then it did it right the next time. So a lot of capabilities, but this particular tool, as you can see just from this demo, this is not a very helpful one. And before we go any further, if you're enjoying this video, please hit that like button. And also, at least per YouTube, about 15% of the people that watch these videos actually subscribe to the channel. So if you're interested in NetSuite or you're looking to make a career with NetSuite, I come out with new videos every single week, tutorials, informational videos, all kinds of stuff. So if you want to subscribe, you can get advantage of all of that and it really helps out the channel. And if you're looking for further training, I do have a course website with about 10 courses on it. So you can check out that link above and you can check out anything from administrator training, inventory management, CRM, accounting, all kinds of things on there. So take advantage of those resources. And with that, let's keep going. So the second AI feature that NetSuite rolled out was related to the NetSuite planning and budgeting module. And I'm actually not gonna walk you through that in NetSuite, mainly because in my experience, a lot of clients don't end up going with planning and budgeting. It's not a cheap add-on. And I find that a lot of clients, they either have an existing budgeting system or they just don't need NetSuite's planning and budgeting module. So for that reason, to do a whole walkthrough with that would be quite involved, and I just don't think it's particularly worth it. The simplicity of it is they've infused some AI into the predictive aspects of the budgeting and kind of can tell you where you might want to plug in certain gaps in the budget, things like that. I haven't had a lot of time to play around with this tool, but so far it seems like, similar to the other AI tools, it's kind of nifty. It has some cool aspects to it, but it's not perfect. Again, it's kind of cool to talk about, but especially when you're dealing with planning and budgeting, which very few clients use in the first place, there's just not too much to talk about, and it's not a huge selling point for NetSuite. And so the third AI tool that NetSuite recently rolled out is their bill capture option, which utilizes OCR. You might have heard that term already. That stands for optical character recognition. And really what it's doing is it's going to scan a bill. Let's say you have a PDF of the bill in the system. It can scan through that and it can recognize certain fields and letters and characters and try to extract information from those fields and match it up with relevant information in the system. So let's take a look at this bill capture feature. All right, so we're gonna go to transactions, down to payables, and over here to scanned vendor bills. So I'm gonna open that. And it opens this tool. So, and I think this is a pretty helpful tool. You know, you can pretty easily see these bills that have already been uploaded. But really what you want to do is you want to bring in a new file here. So you can do this a few different ways. You can either drag and drop, you can open up from a specific location. You can also have emailed bills come in, go to a specific location that will automatically bring it into this tool. So in this particular case, I'm going to select a file. I'm going to come here and right here on my dashboard, I have a test invoice. So I've got it attached and I'm going to upload that. And it gives you these little features saying, good, it's successfully uploaded. You've got it available now. And then it lets me know that this thing is now exactly ready for review. So great, let's actually pull that up. I'm going to hit refresh first. And then I'm going to come to the upload date. So the current upload date you can see right here, this test invoice. This is the one we want to look at. So I'm going to come over here and hit review. And I didn't cut any time there. So it is a pretty rapid import process and scanning feature. It doesn't have to take a long time. And the way this tool works is it pulls the actual invoice up on the left, and then it has basically a new bill that it's creating on the right. So you can do an automatic comparison and see if it got the information right. This invoice, this is something I just pulled up. I grabbed it off the internet as like kind of an example of an invoice. So it's not going to be able to match up the vendor or the items, but there are certain fields that it should be able to figure out. So let's see how well it did. I'm going to zoom in on this a little bit. And I know that's probably tiny on your screen, but hopefully you can get it. Some concept. We've got like front and rear brake. The total is $154.06. There's also some payment conditions at the bottom here. So now let's take a look at what it populated. If we look here, so it figured out that the subsidiary is United States. Now it wasn't able to figure out the vendor because obviously I didn't have a vendor, but it did recognize that East Repair Inc. was what's supposed to be the vendor and it just couldn't find that in the system. So it did a good job with that. It did pull in the correct date, which again, this is just an invoice I pulled off the internet. So this is from 2019. It's got a little reference number there. If we come down here, it does give a due date, which is correct. And it came out with the correct calculated amount, $154.06. So it got that right. Location, it tried to pull the location that it found on the invoice, but again, it's not gonna match up with the information I have in my NetSuite account. And if I come here and I go to items, so it attempted to pull in the line items, which is great. It pulled in, one was $100, one was $15, but of course it didn't have any of these items in the system, so it didn't know what to populate these things with. And in terms of payment terms, again, it was able to figure out the payment is due within 15 days. That just doesn't match up with any payment terms that I already have in NetSuite. So as long as you've got your NetSuite account configured appropriately and you have that basic information in your account, it actually does a pretty good job of scanning a random invoice, populating fields and trying to shove them into a new bill. So if you can have it appropriately set up, I actually think this is a very helpful tool. And just to show you how you would wrap this up, let's say you filled in any information that you want. You can come in here. If you don't have all the info as of yet, you can save for later. But let's say it did a pretty good job and I just had to maybe put in a couple additional fields of info. I would come here and I would hit create bill. That would be for this particular bill. As you saw, there was a whole bunch of bills already scanned in the system. So you can rapidly go through these and bring in those bills, have them scanned, populate those new bills, and pretty easily chew through and take what would generally be a relatively tedious task of bringing a lot of bills into NetSuite and make it much more rapid. So that's the bill capture tool. Again, I think it's quite effective and I'm sure they're gonna hone it in even more as time goes on. Maybe they'll bring in a feature where if the vendor's not here, you can simply click a button and now add that vendor in as a new vendor in the system. That would be great. So with that, the last thing that I wanna show you is actually not something that released in April. This is a tool that came out in 2023 in the first release. So it came out a year prior. And technically, it's not even AI, but it's in the same kind of vein of tools that are a little bit more intelligent, that are trying to make your life easier and things more efficient. So I've noticed that a lot of clients are not even really aware that it's there. And even consultants sometimes have seen it, but they just don't know what it actually does and if it's helpful. So I wanted to point it out for you. Hopefully it's something you can utilize. So this particular feature, I'm gonna come back to my home dashboard. This is a feature when you're creating new transactions, it can intelligently try to figure out what the line items are for those transactions. So for example, we're gonna come to a sales order And on the sales order, of course, I'm gonna have to put in a customer. You wanna have a customer in this particular case, if we're doing a sales order, one that has some historical data. Obviously, if it's a brand new customer, it's not gonna be able to look and figure out what this customer's done in the past and what it should purchase in the present. So you wanna have one that has maybe been purchasing from you for several months, et cetera. So I'm gonna put in a client, Smith Supplies. That's one who's bought, at least in terms of this demo account, they've purchased a lot of things from us. So I bring in Smith Supply. Once I have that information, I can come down here, and you may have seen this button and just never used it, but we've got right here, intelligent recommendations. And you can see there's even a little number there, 10. So if I click on that, it brings up this tool. And really what it's doing is it's just looking at that customer, it's saying, what have they bought before? And these are probably things that you wanna add to this sales order in the present. There's certain instances where this could be very helpful. Obviously, depending on your industry, if customers don't tend to buy the same thing over again, then maybe this isn't very helpful. But if you are in a situation where customers tend to repeat buy, and especially when they're not just buying one thing, but they're buying several line items on any one order, this tool is actually can make things quite efficient because, for example, let's say on this particular order, right, there's a new order, Smith Supply wants 4 or 5 things from us. I can come in here and I've got all the items that they're probably gonna buy listed out for me. And I can see how much these things cost and what are the quantity available. It's all listed right there. So I could go, all right, well, for this first item, there's gonna be 2 of those or 3 of those. This item down here, there's gonna actually be 5 of those, and this gas and water line, we're gonna do 1 of those and another one of these. I can quickly go through and just punch in exactly what I need, and then I can simply hit add and close. And just automatically, it's gonna take all of those figures and it's gonna populate those line items. And you can see it just filled in these line items here. So instead of what you would usually have to do is click, type in the item name, click on the correct item, wait until that information fills in, click on the quantity, change the quantity to what you want, hit okay, go to add a new line, do the same thing for the second line, et cetera, et cetera. In a very short amount of time with that intelligent recommendation, you can just populate all of those lines, click okay, it fills them in here, and you've saved yourself a lot of time. It's not helpful in every circumstance, but if you do have those kinds of situations, it could really help you out. And that's it for the new AI tools in NetSuite. Now, as you've probably figured out at this point, after all the hype that was at SuiteWorld about NetSuite being fully AI and infused everywhere, I personally was relatively underwhelmed with the first release in terms of what tools did come out. The bill capture tool is definitely helpful, but the text enhance, although kind of cool, is not particularly useful. Maybe it'll be improved, maybe it'll be expanded out. And then the planning and budgeting AI feature, you know, again, it's not bad, but at the same time, there's so few clients that actually use that module. So what is there to talk about? So there's definitely opportunities and areas that I think there could be a lot of, you know, benefit from using AI and places where improvements could be made. I personally would love to see the bank feeds app actually start utilizing AI. I mean, I'd love to see it corrected in general just because it tends to be very troublesome, but you could utilize AI to make it match up transactions much better, as well as potentially propose journal entries that reconcile the accounts, things like that. There's all kinds of different possibilities. So hopefully with the upcoming SuiteWorld, we'll get some more specific announcements about actual tools that are upcoming on the horizon. And for sure, in the NetSuite News monthly videos that are upcoming, I will keep you up to date on that. And of course, I'll tell you after SuiteWorld what they're planning on the near horizon. So with that, I'll see you in the next video.